I do. Please wait for me, Mom. I'll be home very soon. Just how much you meant to me till now. You're so many miles away across the sea.
Yes, I was born in Rafferty, and I was born on the 27th of August, 1930. They delivered me. They didn't have any nursing or any nurses come around in those days. Everyone was born and they had to deliver them. And they had chiefs that had the experience of delivering children. My dad, Hiri Waonui. Father's father was Matu Taira, and Matu Taira married Winnie Winnie. Now, that was my father's father and mother. Now, when he was born, he actually, they had to find a name. And in the early days, those names were very tapu. Those names meant something. It got meaning in every name that they gave the old people. And his name was called Hiri Waonui. Hiri means tapu. Waonui, Wao is the forest. It's the big forest out there at Cape Breton. He was named after that. So his name was Hiri Waonui. It wasn't Hiri Waonui, no. It was Hiri Waonui. So that meant a lot to the family, because in other words, he was named after that forest. And he used to be a great hunter. They all hunted for birds, they hunted for the fish, they hunted for everything. They were the providers for food. They were people who prayed for everything before they went fishing, before everything. That was their living. They felt that these things don't come easily.
To hear your voice and to see your smile. Just how much you meant to me.
My mum was one of a family of about 11. She had about 9 sisters. Some of them died at the time of the flu. She was the one that nursed everybody that was sick. Mum was one that never went out. All she done was look after other people's children. Everybody used to go to church, everybody used to go there, whatever was going they went, but Mum didn't. She had twins, and that twins was myself and my brother. And an old lady Kuya at that time with high status of some chieftainess or something, and turned around and said, "The name, you get those children for me, I'll head them. You've got too many children." And she said, "Well, if you did," Mum said, "No, I'm going to keep them." She said, "Well, name them, your twins." So she named my brother Piri. And my name was Te Aroha. And Piri in Māori means close together. And of course, Te Aroha means love, close together in love. Like that. These were her two twins. And she said, "There's no better name than that, Ke Piri Te Aroha." Her father, William Parker, came back to build the house and help because Clanidia was saying, oh, I hate that. Over there, I won't have my boys. But that's on Third Island. It's the big house. That was made much later. Yeah, because that was built by the grandfather, Mum's father. When he was over in Thursday Island, came back and built it. But she did came back, and then she had all these girls, one after the other. So the last two were the two boys, and she turned around. William Parks turned around and said, son, your sons, you've come too late. Really wanted the boys to take over the business. And anyway, he used to come backwards and forwards. So he left it to his partner, which was a European man. And that was his partner. And said, take care of it and all this and that. And he went and sold a lot and he just took off. And William Parks was so downhearted, that was the end of him. Up in the cemetery up at Rafferty. He's buried there. Well, he brought two slaves out to Rafferty to take care of Mum and them. They were still children. And then two of them, both of them died. And then one was buried with Parks. And one was buried outside of the cemetery. And they said because, or something, he came from somewhere else or something. So the people at that time said, well, we're not having any strangers in our cemetery. So they buried him outside the cemetery. So much later on, as the old people died one by one, Mum dug him up and put him in the cemetery. You know, they had, Aborigine names. But Mum felt really sorry for them because they were the people who really brought them up. Not Granny and Ian. They fed them, they dressed them and all these things. Took them out walking and made sure they weren't bitten by the snakes or whatever. Their safety was most important. So Parks used to make sure. That's on Third Island. But as I say, there was two of them that he brought here. They never went back. They're buried here. He was a very lovely person. Everyone loved her. Her father, William, didn't want her to be called any name like that. It got no meaning to him, so he said, call her Annie. So he called her Annie, and that was her name. But the Māori still call her Annie, so it's like a pet name, or you know. And so she became Annie. So on her certificate, you'll find this Annie, this Nana, this Annie, there's Annie, and so forth. So we're having a bit of difficulty with it, trying to get it right now. And she had long hair sometimes. She had two plaits, and she'll have it there. She'll have it, and she'll knot it. And you roll up a knot. She never had ribbons. There weren't ribbons in the time. And she always had a skirt now. She had a skirt, and it was made out of sacks, you know. It's either a flour sacks or sugar sacks, and anything that came in sacks, she had that. And she used to go out on the garden, and her gumboots was her favorite shoes. She never wore anything out but her gumboots. Everything was sewed by hand. Our sheets were sewn by hand, everything. Made clothes. And you look at her and said, oh, look, she got champion flower for a top, you know, something like that, you know. And that's what we wore to school, as well as the sugar sack. Yeah, she was lovely. She had all the patience in the world. And when she saw somebody coming, the first thing she would grew, she started to get deaf, and she grew and she saw that person, hi, and she says, hi to my, which means welcome, and she'll always smile, always had a lovely smile, no matter who it is. And then when they want to put the road through, it was only mother here, so the best that Mum could ever do was to sit in their house and let them plough her over if they had to. At that time when I was crying to her and telling her to come out, she would do it, you know, because this is the law. And she said, oh, in a taurikana, in other those things, you know, the taurikana is a swearing word. You know, na pokokohu, go and cook your head in a pot. That's their swear word. And she said, no, let me die so the rest of my Māori people will know what happened. I can do the best I can. And the kids and the mokapunas were crying that was Francie and him and all, you know, but he was only a little kid. And she still sat there, and I was crying, hey, ma, ka mate koe, hey, yaha. Said, mate au, mokoutou mana mokupuna mo te whenua for our land. Anyway, he couldn't do it, so he went and he rung up the boss. Can you come down and put her out if you want? You plough her over, you're not going to get out. So he said, oh, never mind. So they left her She'd done it on her own. That's what it is. And that hurts Mum. She wanted me to be a nurse for back home. And she had no money, so I had to work for my money, pay my board, and that was with Aunt Celia, and that was my second home. And I had to pay my way through there, milking cows with Ben, catching the bus, 8 o'clock, come home, milk again, 30 cows, 15 between us, two by hand, milking. And then I went to college, me and a friend, which was Heperis from at Waimate. And then her and I went to school, but we weren't learning anything. We were too mischievous. And then we dodged a lot of things. So when we came to exams, we never knew a thing, and we went together. Now, what is your answers? What's your answer? And we both copied, you know, and we both had the same subject, both wrong. Dad was sick. Mum wanted me to finish school and come back and look after Dad. And when he came back, I never ever went back to school again. But that was my college days. A tutor, those are the refs from over at Mangere. She decided that I should go over there and look after my uncle, who was in the same position as my dad, who was going blind. I had to look after him. And then every Saturday, I had to cook big meals. They said, hey, that you know, our girl needs a partner. Well, that was the time. And, you know, they said, oh, I think he makes a good partner. He makes a good partner. So one evening, they said, now don't forget to cook the kai, plenty more. I said, who's all these people coming over here tomorrow? And he said, Waikato. I said, that's all, Waikato, who are they? Oh, you'll find out when they come here. I said, why are they coming here? He said, dear, I must tell you, but don't be afraid. He said, come here to Tomoyu. That is when they've got a man for me to marry. When my time comes to me, it doesn't matter. I'm ready to accept it, but enjoy it as long as you've got life. Okay?
Yes, I do.
Hi. Hello.
Just how much you meant to me till now. You're so many miles away.
Now you can stand again. Look, Nana.
Across the sea.
I need you to take a photo of you. Sit
down. Only God knows where or when.
Look at them. Look at the camera.
We'll meet again.
Smile.
To hold you in my arms.
Smile.
Once more.
This is the way you look at these guys are looking. Ah, oh, David, good for your dad.
To hear your voice. And to see your smile. Just how much you meant to me till now. You're so many miles away across the sea. Again.